हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज शिवम दिवाकर ओवर हियर एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व सेम ट्री प्रॉब्लम फ्रॉम लीड को डेली चैलेंज. सो द क्वेश्चन इज गिवन टू बाइनरी ट्रीज, राइट अ फंक्शन टू चेक इफ दे आर द सेम और नॉट. ओके, टू बाइनरी ट्रीज आर कंसिडर्ड द सेम इफ दे आर स्ट्रक्चरली आइडेंटिकल एंड द नोड्स हैव द सेम वैल्यू. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स से वी हैव दिस ट्री, सो ओके इट्स सेज इट्स ट्रू राइट. And given this 1, 2, this 1, 2, okay, so this will be false because here 1, 2 is at the left, and here 2 is at the right side, so it's not same, right? And here also it's because 2 and 1 both have swapped their positions, so it's false. So let's go to the solution part and see what I'm going to do, because it's a small, just very small amount of thinking that is required. The thing is, let's say the example that we have, the first example, which is, let's say this is 1. Okay, yeah, so this is 1. Here I have 2. Here I have 3. Again, I have 1 over here. I have 2. I have 3. Let's first check how I am telling whether this tree, both the trees are identical or not. So, this is a root R. This is also a root R. This is the peak tree and this is the Q tree. Okay, so P, first I would be given this root, so P root, the root of this P, P dot root, which will give me the root, so it will be P dot root. Okay, so the first thing I would check is whether this P dot root and Q dot root, whether the two roots are same or not. So P dot root and Q dot root, if they are null, okay, in the first instance, then also we'll say okay, the both trees are identical. All right, now if they have some tree, so they won't be null. So if p dot root and q dot root are same, which means here we have 1 and here also we have 1, so both are identical, which means they are same. So the next thing that I will do is I will check for the left subtree of this one. Okay, so I'll iterate to p dot left, which will bring me to 2. Okay, so p dot left will give me 2 and q dot left will also give me 2. So now if p dot left is equal to q dot left, okay, the data in p dot left and in q dot left, so that is also same in this case, which means it is true. Then again we will iterate for q dot p dot left. Now p is here and now q is here. Okay, so now again p dot left will give me null and q dot left will also give me null. Okay, so now we will iterate for this right part. For this right part again we'll have null, again we have null over here. Now the left part is done, and from the left part we got okay, both that first what we did is we checked for whether this left part was equal to this one. The left part of the one in both the P and Q tree had a value which is similar in both of them or not. So here is 2, here also we have 2. Now the left part of P dot left will also iterate the left part of that as well as the right part of that, and same thing we are going to do over here. Now the left part is done and we found that the left part was true. Now in case we had here 3, okay, we have a 31, and in case I had 4 over here, so what would have happened? I went from 1 dot root, 1 dot left, okay, so this p dot left to 2. Now I am here again, I'll go to p dot left 31, again I'll go to q dot left, which is 4. So this is clearly not equal, which means from here if any at any instance this happens, that whether the data and p where let's say what are we having in the question is it's let's say the okay, so left, right and val. Okay, so in our case it would be p, since p is here, p dot left okay will give us here and q dot left will show us over here. So now p dot data, is it equal to q dot data? No. Okay, so in that case it would be false. So this is a very same approach that we are going to do in the code. Okay, what I did is I first checked for the root part. If the root, which is p dot val, okay, the root we would be given in the function, the root will be given p and q. Okay, so if p and q are null, then also it's true, and if it is not null, then we have to check for the data in p and q. Okay, if they are not null together, they are not null. Okay, there might be a case that this is 1 and in q we have 0, so that also is not a considerable case. All right, so yeah, moving ahead. So now we had p at this point, q at this point. Okay, so p dot data and q dot data are same. Now we need to iterate to the left part of p. So p dot left okay, and we'll also pass this q dot left. Okay, that would be 2 here. So now we will again check whether this p dot data, so that p and q comes at this 2 and 2 now at a new function call. So now p dot data and q dot data are same. So now again we'll iterate to the left part, p dot left, q dot left, and now p will be over here and now q will be over here. So now again p dot data, q dot data we will be checking, but since this is not equal, so we'll return false. And if they have been equal, like let's say we did not had, I mean we were not having this p over here, all right, so what would I have done? Okay, so this p dot left pointed me to this point. Okay, so now at p and this q, so p dot left, q dot left is having to equal. We'll next iterate to p dot left, q dot left, but we don't have anything null, so we'll not move again. And if at any instance, okay, so this again we'll iterate, but we'll check if this is null. So p dot left will show me somewhere to null, and again q dot left will also point me to null. Okay, and in the beginning of the code I was checking for this p and q not equal to null simultaneously, so this would be a recursive call and this would be doing the same thing. Okay, let's say I have a function over here in which I first check whether both are null or not. Okay, so that condition would be iterable over here because we are calling this again function again and again and again. All right, so this would be a recursive function. So wherein what I would do is again I will call for p dot left, q dot left, which would be null. So p dot p and q would be equal to null, so again that would return me true. So this would return true over here, all right, and this would return true over here, but again we are not completed because we need to iterate for the right part and check that part also. Okay, so true over here, true over here. So now the thing to check here was if p dot data is equal to q dot data, okay, which is one, then p dot left and q dot left I iterated and I had to have true from here, which is true. Now I need to iterate on the right part, so p dot right should be equal to q dot right. So p dot right will point the p2 over here and q2 over here. Now I'll check whether p dot right and q dot right is same or not. If it is same, then we'll iterate to again the right part, again no, we'll iterate to the left part of this part. Again here it is null, so p dot left will point me to this part. Now p will be null, and here also we have q to be null, so this would be null. Then we'll iterate to the right part, from here also we'll have null, from here also we'll have null, which would be same. Now since whenever we get a null we return true, so true would be returned over here and this would return true over here. So if this p dot data is equal to q dot data and this p dot left part and q dot left part are same and p dot right part and q dot left, right part are same, then only we are going to say that our tree is correct. So this is the same thing that we are going to do in our coding part, and moreover this will be a recursive call. All right, so let's, okay, I need to refer this while writing the code, right? So I'll keep this part. Okay, it's not storing. Okay, this one tree can also help me in figuring out the rest parts. Okay, let's check. So let's check, let's first, when we are coming, we'll have p and q, so it might be a thing that if both are null, so if p is equal to null and q is equal to null, we are going to do nothing but return true. Cool. Now the condition arises. Now see, the condition is, let's say if we have another tree over here and the p and q was not null, so we need to check for that condition now. So if p is not equal to null, we'll check. Okay, and the q also need not to be null, it has not to be null, I mean the q should not also be null at the same time, because if either of them happens to be a null, so we would not go inside this, rather we will go out. Okay, at any instant, this is a recursive function, right? And we'll simply return false. So now what to do inside? We have to do nothing, but we have to simply, what we have to do here is that we have to simply return. Now what do we need to return? We need to return whether this data containing in this p, okay, so what is p dot data? No, p dot val. Okay, so p dot val should be equal to q dot val at any instant. Okay, without double equal to is there, yeah, all right. And now if it is same, we need to iterate to the left part. So left part is this is same tree, and again now to the right part. Once to the left and then to the right, and all of these values has to be returned true. And if at any instant it's not true, it would be false and the tree won't be equal. Okay, so now we need to iterate to the left part. So p dot left comma q dot left. All right, so the left part of both, and now to the right part of both, which would be p dot, since we have p and node tree p, node tree q. Okay, yeah, so p dot right. Okay, p dot right. Yeah, p dot right, and then q dot right. Okay, so it's almost there. Let's check this out. Okay, so it says it's accepted, right? So guys, thank you for watching, and stay tuned to our channel, and we are hosting our online coding event, so please do check that out also. So thank you for watching.